The reason I call it hypocrisy is this. What they say they want to do, which is reduce government spending, they don't. What they only do it on particular groups of people. And the other is something called the consequences of the shutdown. Let me just say this. They want to cut spending, but they're unwilling to cut their own pay. Sure, I'm for a government that's more frugal. I'm for cuts, but I'm not for their cuts. What they propose is reckless and radical. And when they don't get their own way, they say, cut it or shut it. However, I say take this position. If there is a government shutdown, I don't think that members of Congress should be paid. If there is a government shutdown, and we tell dedicated federal employees that they're not going to get paid, that they're non-essential, well, the fact that we couldn't stop a shutdown shows we're non-essential. And I believe if there is a shutdown, members of Congress should not get paid. I not only want to express that as a sentiment, I did that backing Senator Barbara Boxer's bill, which passed the Senate, that said if there is a shutdown, members of Congress don't get paid. Now, what did the House Republicans do? They passed a bill that I won't go into the details, but on this relevant section, they said, oh, members of Congress and the president doesn't get paid. But guess what? They allow for retroactive payment. Now, the Senate bill doesn't do that. So they would be the only ones in shutdown that can come back and pick up that little paycheck that they have stuck in a corner. You talk about hypocrisy? That's called bait and switch. It ought to be under some kind of consumer protection law. Even the title of their bill is wrong. Their bill says the Government Shutdown Prevention Act. Well, their bill doesn't stop a shutdown. It doesn't even help with a sit-down. What is a sit-down? Where we would come to the table and as grown-up Americans, we would try to arrive at how to pass a continuing resolution to fund the government that recognizes not only debt, but that there are certain aspects of the government program we need to be able to fund. In my home state, I'm the home of the National Institutes of Health. Right now, I have thousands of people working as a team to find the cure for Alzheimer's, for AIDS, for autism, for cancer. You know, we race for the cure, and we should, but oh no, we're going to tell those researchers that they're non-essential. Right now, I represent I represent the headquarters for the Social Security Administration. Right now, there are thousands of federal employees processing the claims of Social Security, making sure someone who's disabled qualifies their benefit. They're going to be told they're non-essential. Well, let me tell you this, Mr. President, on any given day, if somebody in whatever town they live goes to their Social Security office and find it shuttered because they cannot apply for a benefit that they believe they're eligible for, I think they would rather shut us down than Social Security offices be shut down. And if you ask anybody in the United States of America, who do you think's more essential? Members of Congress? Or the researchers working on a cure for cancer, or for those people working to defend our borders.